for joining us live for NBA Basketball on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. And the Wizards on friendly ground as they continue this homestand. Last time they came together was in Charlotte, where they fell to the Hornets. Whatever they can do to avoid a sweep here, they'll need to rebound and do it, but the momentum is definitely not in their favor.
Their defense got absolutely destroyed in that game, guys. They weren't closing out on the perimeter shooters. They were allowing people to get into the paint and score. From point-blank range, just an overall abysmal effort.
Yeah, something was missing, no doubt about that. They let an opponent shoot a really high percentage, and that's got to be a concern going forward.
Here's the starting group for the Charlotte Hornets. At the three, MKG and Cody Zeller at the four. Ryan Roberts out there with Easy Breezy, and it's Jefferson in at center.
Paul Pierce, a 16-year veteran, and last season his first not in a Celtics uniform. It took some getting used to, both for him and for us.
Here's Temple, and he's off on his first shot of the game.
Well, they'll give him that shot. He doesn't have the most reliable jump shot in the world, we know that.
Stolen by Nene. Two on one as they jump out on the break. Temple dishes to Serafin. To the wing on the left. Back to Pierce. Just five on the clock. Front pass the arc. That's good. Pierce has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
There they go. Finally able to drop one in on their fourth try.
And Roberts kicks to Kidd Gilchrist. He feeds it to Jefferson. Rebounded by the Wizards. Defeated by the Pacers in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
And, you know, coming down the stretch in that game, they didn't have all the guys they would have liked on the floor because of the foul trouble they were in.
And as a result, Steve, they had to back down a little bit so they wouldn't get themselves into even more foul trouble.
Here's Roberts after the made shot from Bradley Beal. Passes it to Martinez. He tries for three. Here's Jefferson, and the rebound goes to Nene. Wizards have gone 2 of 5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game.
Well, great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, it sure was. He made a beeline for the bucket as soon as they got the ball. Right away, straight to the rim.
Now here's Jefferson, right now averaging 17 points a game.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Nicely done.
Wizards have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Beal, the pass to Pierce. And there's the feed to Temple. It's Beal on the wing. He's covered by Kidd Gilchrist. And that one's good by Pierce.
You're going to be waiting a long time if you're waiting for him to miss that when he's that open.
Roberts dishes to Zeller. And it's Kidd Gilchrist penetrating. Here's Martinez, and he drops it in from the low post. Martinez has got 7 points. The Wizards have gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first. Here's Serafin. The shot no good. And Charlotte will come the other way. They're coming off that win against the Nets.
I thought the way they attacked the rim and got into the paint was phenomenal. It seemed like after a while, the defense just kind of waved the white flag.
That's exactly what will happen when a team continues to attack the goal and come away with layups. It demoralizes the defense.
So it's Washington now, following the score by Charlotte. And there's Bradley Beal on the assist by Pierce. And it's 6 points here for Beal. And a new group getting ready for the Wizards. Gortat's checked in for Kevin Serafin. Humphreys comes in.
All right, you're up.
Oh, yeah.
Hornets leading by six. They've got Garrett Temple, He's out there with Bradley Beal. Kevin Serafin is out there with Rasul Butler. That's the group on the floor right now for Washington. Here's Zeller, a beautiful reverse layup. Zeller's got his first points of the game.
The D was all over. They just couldn't react in time. Quick reverse.
Martinez, he's checked in for Charlotte. Washington's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris.
Hi, guys. Easy breezy in their last game against the Nets, got down to business. He ended with 25 points and a lot of his contribution coming from the charity stripe as he was drawing fouls. A truly dominating game from him in what was hopefully a sign of things to come. At least that's how the franchise is thinking, guys.
All right, Doris, thanks. That really was a spectacular game for him, even by Steve Hiss standards.
Well, those are pretty high standards ordinarily. We'll see how much it carries over. It's not a performance that will be easy to repeat.
But you like to have that in your arsenal and on your resume so you can call on it the next time you get out on the court. So I think it'll serve him better than it won't.
Dishes it to Butler. Lock at six. Hangs in midair and converts on the double clutch layup. Butler's got 4 points now in the quarter. Hornets leading by eight. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Here's Roberts, averaging 6 points per contest. Here's Zeller. He dishes it to Roberts. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
Had so much space there, and the defense really not showing him the respect. You can see his eyes get wide.
And Beal kicks to Temple. Pass to Serafin. Kid Gilchrist with the steal. Here's Martinez. Shot is off.
And... Well, guys, I'm here with Bradley Beal. And, Bradley, we've heard Coach stress the importance of rebounding. Is that going to have to be a team effort in the second half for all five players?
Hey, guys, listen up. We've got a good lead, but lots of basketball left to play. Very nice offensive first half from the
And the first quarter about ready to get underway. Look at Al Jefferson. He's really been playing well.
Yeah, he tore it up on the offensive glass in the first couple of quarters. Love the effort you're getting out of him.
Incredibly persistent, which is what it takes to be a successful offensive rebounder. I should know, I used to eat a lot of glass in my day.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now. Brought to you by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. Setting the four for the Hornets. At the three, MKG and Cody Zeller at the four. Easy breezy out there with Brian Roberts. And it's Jefferson in at the five. And Pierce, here we go. Shoots a fader. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
It's been a great day for them on the boards, Clark. That's definitely been a major factor in building this big lead.
And, you know, from a number standpoint, the advantage might not be that large, but they have been manhandling them inside.
Martinez outside, just four to shoot. Pulls up, high post. Beal pulls it in.
And a missed opportunity right there.
Definitely, I think he should have converted that one.
Well, the Wizards very high on their young, athletic backcourt of John Wall and Bradley Beal. Both so young and lively, they can run the floor and score. I get the feeling they feel like the backcourt is really the foundation for this franchise moving forward.
It's rebounded by Martinez. Hornets leading by 13. Releases from 15, and the shot is good. Martinez has got 5 points now this quarter. And Beal with his great outside shooting, a nice compliment to John Wall.
You know, you watch Wall, how much he's improved as a shooter, but he's best really attacking off the dribble. With Beal spacing the floor, I think they make a nice 1-2 punch.
Gortat's checked in for Serafin. Jefferson against Gortat. Nene setting the pick for Gortat. Pierce the pass to Beal. Back to Pierce. Just five on the clock. Nene, and he uses the glass on the layup. Charlotte making some changes. Gerald Henderson, he's checked in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And Walker subbed in for Brian Roberts. Walker dishes to Henderson. Kicks to Zeller. Knocked loose. And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession. Charlotte making a switch here. Stevens.
That's the way to shoot the rock.
Into the lineup for the Hornets. Lance Stevenson.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. And Walker kicks to Stevenson. Pass to Henderson. It's a nice pass in here by Charlotte. Here's Jefferson. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials on the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Al Jefferson is really a unique scorer inside. He doesn't shoot a lot of free throws. He doesn't tally that many assists. What he does do is make shots inside while taking great care of the basket.
Wizards making a switch here. Humphreys checked in. Martinez, he's checked in for the Hornets. And Jefferson with the excellent pump fake. Unusual, Steve, in that it really looks nothing like his shot. He just lifts the ball, and defenders always seem to bite on it.
Yeah, you know, it's that deception. And sometimes it looks, you know, almost comical, and yet defenders go for it. So it's obviously an effective move. And I think it's also his mentality. He's trying to trick defenders and elude them instead of, you know, trying to draw contact. Risky shot there. Size-wise, I mean, he easily comes out on the short end of the stick, so to speak.
With the nice high release, he had no problem getting it off and knocking it down.
Temple the pass to Beal. He kicks to Humphreys. The pass to Beal. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Shoots from the elbow. Another one falls for Washington.
You know, he's knocking down his shots today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
Walker the pass to Martinez. The 10-footer. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Martinez has got 7 now in this quarter. Wizards trail by 14. Here's Temple. Feeds to Beal. That doesn't go either for Beal.
Well, an 8-rebound advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference.
For Washington, they've gone 3-6 in the third quarter, 50% from the field. Picked by Humphreys. Temple dishes to Pierce. The Wizards need to get a shot off here. Beal from long range. Beal can't get that one to fall. Charlotte leading by 14. And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, gentlemen, as you know, great post-scoring is a bit of a lost art in the NBA, but Al Jefferson is a throwback player. He said, you know what gets me going? When I spin to the baseline real quick, get you off your feet, go under you, and throw it up fast. That's better than any windmill or 360 dunk I could ever do. Kevin?
Oh, well, well, drop right down low. Thank you, Doris.
I love Jefferson's great footwork on the low box. I mean, he's always keeping defenders off balance.
Looking at who's out there now for the Wizards. Artel Webster, he's checked in for Pierce. And it's Butler in for Bradley Beal. To the right side. Martinez outside. Walker the pass to Martinez. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face. Martinez has got 9 points now in the quarter. Wizards trail by 18. Here's Temple. Gortat with a screen on Walker. And Temple kicks to Webster. The dish to Gortat. He feeds it to Temple. Butler attacking. And he's got his first free throw of the game. And he can't get the first one. So both teams changing it up here.
At the line for 2.
And he's good on the second. Now Stevenson. 6 points for him. out to the right wing. And another three for Charlotte.
They're playing with a purpose, guys. The big lead becoming bigger. I like the look in their eyes.
And it's on both ends that they've been controlling the action.
Temple, and another miss by Washington. And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout.
Coming up next Wednesday night, April 1st, the Chicago Bulls take on Larry Sanders and the Milwaukee Bucks. You don't want to miss it.
And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
Well, this is what you talk about when you have the offensive play coming together based on tremendous passing. It's the rhythm and flow that occurs that makes this a beautiful game.
Webster and Nene, they're the forwards. Garrett Temple is out there with Rasul Butler. And it's Serafin in at the center, locking down the middle. That's the five on the floor for the Wizards. The kick outside to Butler. Passes to Serafin. The third shot of the possession finally falls for him. Serafin's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Wizards. Stevenson passes to Martinez. Back to Stevenson. Stevenson off the pick from Martinez. Three-pointer. Stevenson can't hit. Wizards trail by 18. Webster can't get the bucket.
Not too much congestion in the lane. I think he could have gotten a better shot that time, no question.
Here's Martinez. And it's off target. Not sure why he took that one.
Well, that's not really his game. I mean, he shouldn't be shooting the ball from out there.
Webster dishes to Temple. Nene, the screen. There's the feed to Butler. Right side, Butler, the 17-footer. And he knocks down the jumper. Washington making some changes. Paul Pierce has checked in for Webster. And Bradley Beal subbed in for Rasul Butler. Jefferson's checked in for Charlotte. And he jams it with authority.
He's their go-to guy, and when he shoots the ball like he has today, that's what the scoreboard usually looks like.
Here's Temple. Nene outside. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. The shot by Pierce will not go.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
And Roberts kicks to Kidd Gilchrist. Here's Martinez. No good from outside. Wizards trail by 18. Temple the pass to Nene. Here's Temple, covered by Martinez. Pierce with another miss.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Martinez drives in, and good on the basket. Book it. Martinez has got 11 in the second half.
They've built this lead through plays exactly like that. He's easily been their most... most consistent performer.
Well, he's been splashing everything today.
Nene, the screen. There's a good screen. And here's Beal. Here's the three. Here's Serafin. And even after two offensive rebounds, they just can't get the lid off. And Kidd Gilchrist kicks to Roberts. Martinez outside.
Some fantastic numbers here for Easy Breezy. He has 18 points. He's done a little bit of work behind the arc. He's got a pair of three-pointers.
Well, the defenders have that in the back of their minds now, too, so they're going to close out on him quicker. That should allow him to use the drive if he wants. Oh, there's so much talk about the intentional foul, whether it's good for the league or not. Some people say, hey, keep the rule, make the guys make the free throw. If you can't make a free throw, then the coach has to take them out. On the other hand, it's boring to watch. It slows the game down. I'd like to see the elimination of the rule. Don't let a foul fest go on and just have a parade to the foul line.
Dishes it to Roberts. There's the steal. Pass to Temple. No one near him. And that one's good. 1:52 left in the fourth. Pass to Martinez. And what was that about? Not a good shot right there. Wizards trail by 16. And Pierce, here we go. Nene dishes to Pierce. Here's Temple. And Beal kicks to Nene. The fader. Rebounded by Martinez. Martinez has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
Well, this is going to end in a lopsided victory, obviously. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness and the ability to close. You really have to give it up for the Hornets.
And the big difference here was accuracy behind the three-point line, Clark.
Well, they started spraying them from deep, and then it spread out the defense, and they had all the looks they wanted.
And on the year, looking at their record, this game will make it 49 wins.
We're capping off this season series in just the way we would have expected out of a team that has already won the previous three encounters.
You know, we don't see the four-game sweep between conference opponents very often. This has been utter domination.
Five to shoot. Shoots a three. No good. Now Washington takes it the other way. 29 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pierce kicks to Temple. There's 18 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And he gets it to go. Eleven seconds left to play here in the fourth. Here's Roberts. So no problem for Charlotte as they get the win. Some days, Clark, everything goes right for a team, and they just had one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball.
Well, Gerald, we know you demand a lot of yourself.
Things are happening fast. I'm talking freight train fast. I hope you're ready to take that first step toward that big shoe deal you've been dreaming of for so long.
Man, what are you talking about now?
Jordan and Nike are interested in you. Very interested.
What? Why didn't you just say that?
Because I masked my own crippling insecurities in an avalanche of words. My analyst says it's a flaw. But now that we're friends, I think we can be honest with each other. And besides, the timing wasn't quite right.
Listen, we're not friends. But what else?
All right, there's a catch you may not like. The gatekeeper of this here deal used to play in the league until his knee exploded like a Chinese New Year parade. Ha-ha! My man!
What? Jackson Ellis?
In living color, in the flesh, large and in charge. You name it, I am it, and here I am.
Oh, nah, this is personal. Oh, so you working for Nike and Jordan now?
Fun twist, right?
I mean, that's one way to put it.
Game's coming together, like what I see. We're watching, and we're interested.
But what?
It's early. You're still not that far removed from being a 10-day contract nobody. And this company didn't get to be number one by dealing with nobodies.
Well, you know what? It's too bad that we can't play one-on-one for it if you broke me.
Yeah, too bad.
Hmm.
You know, when I was playing this game, dominating the NBA, it was my whole existence. No girlfriend, no wife, every day. this was it. So when the doc told me I was done, it was like my soul got ripped from my body. I was emptied out. I even cried. Real tears. And then this here opportunity came along. A new game. A game I liked even more.
Oh, yeah, and why is that?
Because I always get to choose who wins. I'll be watching.
What do you say? We head out early. Get some shooting up.
Hey, is that obvious, huh?
Everyone's struggling with their shot sometime. Nothing's a trip about. Just gotta get back to work, is all. So what you think?
Cool. I could use all the help I can get. I gotta do something different. You ready now?
Cool. That's some good work out there. You're going to see a difference tonight. Hope the scoreboard operator is ready. We're going to be lighting up all game long. Let's do it.
Hey, I hear that.
Welcome, everyone. This is the NBA on 2K Sports. Coming to you live on this Saturday night. This is Kevin Harlan along with the rest of our 2K broadcast team. Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke. Earlier in the season, the Charlotte Hornets ended up losing their last game in this matchup to Atlanta. So they win one, lose one. Things have been pretty evenly matched so far. One of these teams has to step up.
And, you know, coming down the stretch in that game, they didn't have all the guys they would have liked on the floor because of the foul trouble they were in.
And as a result, Steve, they had to back down a little bit so they wouldn't get themselves into even more foul trouble.
Looking at the starting five for the Atlanta Hawks. Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. On the wings, Korver and Carroll, and it's Schroeder in at the one. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. Here's Walker, averaging 12 points a game. It's off his leg, and it's whistled a kick. Martinez drives in, and he gets the bucket. Martinez has got his first basket of the night. Well, as you know, Clark, he's been in a lengthy slump, but I saw him taking the extra time with some extra shots before this game.
From what I've heard, it was at the suggestion of his teammate. He's been slumping and struggling, and they're both hoping that some extra shots will get him back on track.
Korver kicks to Carroll. Clock is at three. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet.
Well, nice way there to get your first basket of the game.
First quarter, about a minute and a half in. Three-point shooting perhaps never more valued, Clark, than it is right now in the NBA. Kyle Korver, such a great signing for the Hawks.
Yeah, really a good one. I mean, his contract is front-loaded running through 2017 for around the mid-level exception. And quite honestly, he's worth every penny, not just because of his laser shooting ability, but he's a hard-nosed, tough guy, professional in every way, and he just brings a winning presence to whatever team he's on.
Says he learned a lot of his basketball acumen from his mom, who was a terrific player in Iowa.
No question.
And so it's Atlanta with it. After the three-pointer from Martinez, the shot by Carroll no good. Up top, Walker. Back to Martinez. Shot, high post. Another shot. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
How about this? They're shooting 80% so far. I know it's early, but offensively, they look great. Al Jefferson, 6'10", over 280 pounds, and he's got a 9'2" standing reach. He's got the size to play center, but hasn't always been a great defender at that position. I thought Charlotte really put him in a good position last year, however, with their scheme, and he was very effective.
You know, for a guy his size, he doesn't play above the rim very often like he did on that slam.
Still got some power behind him, though.
Yeah, I mean, you let him get in close like that, he'll throw one down hard on you.
Now here's Martinez. He had an 18-point outing in their last game against Washington. Can't connect from short range. And Al Jefferson, not the fleetest of foot, but a good nose for the ball.
You know, he's always been a terrific rebounder, and I've said before that rebounding isn't about how high you jump. It's about how physical you are and how hungry you are to get after the ball and timing and positioning. And he's actually improved defensively, too.
So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Al Horford, the Dominican big man, won two titles.
Dialed in from long range. I like it.
The back titles in 06.
Gary Neal's checked in for the Hornets. The Hawks trail by five, and so in the game for the Hawks. Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. On the wings, Korver and Carroll, and it's Schroeder in at the point. Carroll dishes to Korver, lets it go from deep, and Lance Stephenson pulls it down. And Steve, for Horford, consistently a threat from mid-range. It's curious that he has struggled at the free throw line the last couple seasons.
Yeah, it must be something mental because you think about what a good shooter he is from the outside. Some people have even thought maybe he should shoot threes from time to time. But the free throw line struggles, that's something that's bothered a lot of people over the years, and usually it's a mental block of some sort.
Here's what Charlotte's going with right now. Easy Breezy comes in for Lance Stevenson, and Brian Roberts subbed in for Walker. The basket counts and one. He'll go.